So I'm joined by Paul Treu. Paul, just put that win into words for me.
Oh, it's unbelievable. I mean, for us, I mean, I think we were so unlucky in 8 times throughout the season. And for us, I mean, to come back again, you know, after a disappointing tournament in Hong Kong, and to bounce back and to give this kind of performance. I mean, it's not every day that you're going to beat New Zealand twice in the final. And it's just heads off to our boys. We just wanted to get our quickest team on the field. And South Africa coming back from injury and to give the performance that he did, not quite, you know, the level where he would like to be. But it's good momentum, especially going into the World Cup, you know, in June.
You put high hopes on the Hong Kong tournament, but you've come away with this Tokyo one. It must be just as satisfactory.
Yeah, I think so. You know, everything, every win that's going to come your way that you have to take. And I think we can at least go back to South Africa, a happy team. We'll definitely have to look at our preparation and see, you know, how we can do better in the first tournaments. But this set aside, I mean, for us, we're going to enjoy this win tonight. And like I said, you know, just well done to our guys.
No Kyle and no Paul, but you've got the likes of Cornell and Cecil stepping up.
Yeah, it's still difficult for us. I mean, to get the consistent, you know, almost like New Zealand, we need those key players, and we just hope that they're going to recover soon and get back into this team as quickly as possible, especially for the World Cup in June. But yeah, I think Branko and Cecil and the guys, Siabelos and Natla, I mean, it's the second time that he put Samoa away in the dying seconds of the game. So yeah, it's good for us. You know, we need to build the culture of Sevens in South Africa, and hopefully we've done exactly that.